They radioed in the command, and two policemen brought in the prisoner in handcuffs. And as they were escorting them, the crowd noticed that this criminal was an unfamiliar sight. It was a 14-year-old boy. Now, as he approached the stand, the judge announced to the bailiff that court was now in session. The crime of the boy, he had committed murder to a fellow teenage boy, 4 shots, 2 to the body, 2 to the head, instantly killing the boy. The motive, he was trying to impress his gang. Now, as the trial went on and they were announcing the charges, providing the evidence, the boy was shaking. His hands trembled, his legs buckled, and his body was filled with cold sweat. He was afraid, but not at the idea of going to jail. No. He was afraid of the person that was staring behind him. He could feel the stare burning through his skull. It was a lady, the mother of the victim he had killed. Now this mother sat still and quiet throughout the trial, her eyes puffy and red from the countless nights where she didn't sleep and the amount of times she cried when she got the news of her little boy's death. Throughout the trial, as the judges and they provided the evidence, her fists clenched, her nails biting into her flesh, her skin, the anger, the sadness, the pain, all simmering inside her. But she remained perfectly calm and still. As the verdict was given, and the boy was about to be sent to jail, the police let him out. But before he could leave, the woman finally stood up, went up to the boy, looked him in the eye, said, "I am going to kill you." The boy was then taken to prison, where he served his sentence. And about a year later, the guards opened his cell and told him, "You have a visitor." The boy was confused. He had never had any visitors. And when he went to the visiting room and saw who it was past the glass wall, his face turned in shock. It turned white. It was the mother of the victim who had come to visit him. He wanted to run away, but the mother stood up and, "Wait, wait, I just came here to talk." The boy, confused, but he nodded his head and took a seat in front of her. "So, what do you want to talk about?" He said, "I want to know about you. I want to know why you killed my son." And there, she learned that this boy had lived in the streets, an orphan with no friends, no family. And she was surprised to also find out that she was the first person to visit him. The gang members that he was so proud of trying to get into hadn't bothered to even show up. After a few hours of talking, before she left, she gave him a basket of fruits and snacks. And then she visited again the next day. Now this went on for months and years, until the boy finally turned 18. Now, he was about to be put on parole for good behavior, and so the mother came to visit him again. "What are you going to do when you get out of jail?" The boy confused, and for the first time, he didn't feel like he had a life. And when the realization that he was about to be placed back out in society came hitting him, he said, I have no friends. I lived in the streets. I really don't know what to do." And the mother said, "I have a friend. He owns a little factory, and I think I can get you a job there." The boy was confused at the gesture and said, "Thank you." He said, "Where are you going to live?" asked the mother. And was, I don't know, the streets?" And the mother said, "I actually have a spare room in my house. If you don't mind, maybe you'd like to live." live with me until you can find a better place. The boy nodded in agreement. When he was released, he was introduced to the factory owner, and the mother made sure that he worked hard, made sure that he wasn't getting any free meals. He had to work for the living. He had to make sure that he did everything diligently and educated him, taught him how to be a better person. And after 6 months of this going to work, learning how to be a better person, the mother took him by the side, sat him down in the living room, and asked, "Do you remember the day in the courtroom when you were convicted for killing my one and only son for no reason at all?" And the boy was shocked as the memory flooded back. He looked down, trembling, and said, "Yes, yes, I remember." And the mother held his hand, stared back at him, and said, "Do you remember what I said to you? That I said I was going to kill you?" And the boy couldn't look him in the eye, trembled, and said, "Yes, I will never ever forget that day." And the mother whispered, "I did it." Confused, the boy looked up at her and saw that the mother was in tears and smiled and said, "The boy that murdered my son those many years ago is dead and gone. You are now a different person. That same person is no longer here. I killed him. I made sure to teach you, to show you kindness, to put a roof over your head, to give you a job, so that he would never come back again. And today, you are not that same person." And as he told her this revelation, she began to cry. He began to cry. And they both embraced. I found the story very intriguing because this, in many cases in the world, a lot of us would take revenge against such a person. But this woman had taught us that hate only breeds more hate. And the only way to combat hate is true love. So we will hate, but we will love. And that, back to you.